critical game four, best of seven. Dallas Stars with a 2-1 series advantage. Turned over to Johnston shorthanded. Here's a shot, quick save, rebound. Oh, another save, a score. Second effort. Wyatt Johnston pounding away shorthanded. And even Georgiev couldn't stop that one. Haskinen, and they are isolating. Through the seam, Wyatt Johnston shoots and scores. The 20-year-old has his second of the night. A shorty and a power play goal. Dallas Stars open up a 3-1 series lead. They win 5-1. Dallas trying to close it out at home. Game five on Wednesday night.
Eyes of the hockey world descend on Dallas. This is the only game in the Stanley Cup playoffs tonight. Colorado and the Dallas Stars. And normally I would thank the singer or the band for the opening, but that was Steve Levy. Great voice from ESPN, is one of the nicest men in hockey. So neat to hear Steve. He'll be with Ray Ferraro, Emily Kaplan. You just saw Devon Taves. We think Devon is good to go for Colorado, and that's huge tonight. That man, Wyatt Johnston, incredible, celebrated his 21st birthday on Monday. The Stanley Cup playoffs on Sportsnet, presented by Rogers. 21 on Monday. He's already got 11 career Stanley Cup playoffs. I'd say it's a breakout season, but he had that last year. Just fantastic. Luke Gazdick and Mr. Ice Tilt. It's appropriate we have Justin Bourne here tonight because the ice was tilted in game four of the series. Whatever's going on, we know Nichushkin Taves was bad news and they seem to be zombie apocalypse, but what are they going to try tonight? What's the line?
Well, it looks to me like Jonathan Drouin's going to move up and get the opportunity to play with Nathan MacKinnon. And we know those two have a bit of a track record, so that's one way they're looking to generate a little offense. But the most noteworthy thing to me, you mentioned Devon Taves coming back. I don't know if you guys remember, there's a clip of Taves earlier this season talking about how we got guys in this room who think they're trying, but they're not trying. They have so many motivators in that room. So to have MacKinnon, to have Makar, and now to bring Taves back, I would expect a better push from the Avs tonight.
I feel like he's just such a huge part of that locker room. So big being back for the on-ice portion, but even just being around and the presence of being in the dressing room. But on the Dallas side, obviously some changes too. Roope Hintz will not play tonight. He took a cross check and a slash from game three, and so we're not really sure what happened, but lots of changes in the Dallas lineup. This looks more like the start of the playoffs that Peter Dubois and the Stars showed. But Radek Faksa back in. This gives the fourth line a bit of a different dimension because he can play center and the wing. But Sammy Steele, who's been great and an elite checking forward for them throughout this whole year, will center that fourth line that's been outstanding for Dallas. Everyone's kind of just moving up a bit. Dodonov's back on that third line. Marchman's back up in his second line. And Jamie Benn playing with his, I'll call them nephews, I guess, Uncle Jamie playing with the young kids there. It's been a very dynamic third line. So some changes for Dallas, but still like their lineup a lot.
Yeah, one of his nephews, Wyatt Johnston, has been exceptional. I mean, his scoring throughout the playoffs, you look at a lot of teams, and Pettersson struggling and Toronto Marner struggled. This guy, no issues at all. Most playoff goals before age 21, Wyatt Johnston with 11. Look at this list of guys he's on this with. To me, to be a playoff goal scorer, there are some sort of attributes that go with that, some typical things you do, and it's getting to the middle. And Johnston, all these clips, watch how unafraid he is of being in the middle of the ice, taking it to the Colorado D and saying, you stop me. He's challenging them and genuinely saying, I'm putting on you guys to try to get a hold of me, go into the net here, stopping in the blue paint, doing all those sort of playoff goals thing. This one is such a talented play. He doesn't actually one-time that. It's kind of a two-timer, a one-touch and a quick release. So for Dallas, you look at all the great players they have there. This guy has kind of become scorer number one for them and one of the reasons the Avs are having such a hard time here.
Yeah, and on their blue line, I've really liked the dynamic of how good offensively they are and how good defensively they are as well. If you look on the offensive side, it's been led by Miro Heiskanen, and here's another board for you. Look at the company that he's kept since 2019 in terms of playoff points. He's right up there with some of the best names and some of the best defensemen in the world right now. I love what he brings to the table. A, with his legs. B, with his shot. He's always jumping up in the play. This was so hard for a winger for me when the defenseman slides down back door. You got your head on a swivel. schedule, and he's made no mistake in these playoffs. 7 points in 4 games in this series for him. He does it from the point, always has his head up, incredibly hard to defend. I mean, I can just imagine this is a nightmare for the Avs forwards trying to guard this player. And on the defensive side, you look at Chris Tanev and what he's brought to the Stars since being traded there. Dallas has allowed the fewest goals in the playoffs, and a huge part of that has been blocked shots. There's no team has more blocked shots in this playoffs than Dallas, and Tanev is first on their team and their blue line in blocks with 41. I also love this clip. This is Chris Tanev encapsulated right here. Takes a hit to make a play, and there's Sammy Seal, who I talked about earlier, driving the play, contributing to a goal. So Chris Tanev won't even get an assist on that play, but he makes a lot of difference. Sometimes you don't always see it on the score sheet, though.
That's fantastic. Hey, David Azuma, if you do get a shot, I know ESPN's calling the tune here tonight, but if we get Devon Taves, any news on him, that'd be great. The coaches met with the media earlier today, so let's begin with Peter DeBoer and then Jared Bednar.
The building's been fantastic. The fan base has been great. You know, I love the fact that we've earned home ice advantage through at least, you know, the next round, too, if we can manage to get there. But, you know, having said that, you know, this is always the toughest game to win, the elimination game. And, you know, there's a lot of proud men in that other room with championship rings, you know, and we're going to have to earn it.
I think you can always get wrapped up in worry, anxiety, frustration, like all those things at any point throughout the course of a series. It's supposed to be fun all the time, especially in the playoffs, you know? So I sense our team can get uptight, like just from being with them for so long. There's been times where I've been like, why are we so uptight for, you know, the series is at 2-1 and we've like, what did we think the series was going to be? You know, it was definitely never going to be easy. So yeah, I'm hoping that our guys can take a breath and relax today. We've talked about it and it seems like guys are in a good spot. So the Dallas is going to come at us hard and continue to do exactly what they've done. And it's up to us to respond and play our best game of the series.
You know, the thing about game four, obviously the Nichushkin news was very upsetting. Taves is a huge loss in your roster. But it was game three. Eddie Olczyk noticed something. Started the second period. 1-0 game. Colorado power play. And Nathan MacKinnon goes off after 30 seconds. And it was kind of like just, I don't know if it's stress or confusion or frustration. But what's apparent is that nobody's ready to replace him. They're shocked that he comes off so quickly at the get-go of the second period.
Nobody jumps on for him.
Nobody. Yeah. Finally, Gerard there. But it was a moment. Obviously, Luke, you can see it on the bench. That's game three. That's before all of the news coming into game four.
Well, we talk about this a lot. There's such a human element to hockey, and especially in situations like this. You find out one of your teammates goes through what he did on a game day when your mind is somewhere else at that time. And Ron, you said it, whether it's stress, confusion, frustration, he looked like all of the above. He certainly didn't look like the Nathan MacKinnon that we've all come to grow to love, and his game and the electricity that he brings on a nightly basis and the energy. He looked off is what I'll say. And you could clearly see it with the body language and the mannerisms. You usually don't see him show a ton of frustration this visually. And even plays like this, coming over the blue line where he usually shows such confidence, turning multiple pucks over and clearly visibly frustrated. I don't expect we'll see that Nathan MacKinnon again tonight. He's going to bring, I want to say, a different effort, but this is an elimination game, and I think we're going to see the dog in full force tonight.
Yeah, but there's that emotional element last time, and I don't think it's just that. Like, watching the way Dallas plays defense is just the most frustrating, smothering way possible. Look at this series for Colorado compared to the one before. Slot shots, they're getting 7.5 less a game. Rush chances, 2.5 less a game. Yet the last one's interesting. A little more ozone possession time. We'll get to that in a second, but the rush chances thing, it's fun hockey when you're flying through the neutral zone. Bednar's talking about fun. It's not fun when they always have guys back. Watch Dallas here, always having numbers. It doesn't seem like there's any space for Colorado to go east-west. They've just kind of got to move the puck forward. Look at the four guys in the picture here, shoulder checking, the back guys looking around. Who else can I cover? This is just defending in layers, and this to me is a sign of good coaching. It's good leadership. Just one guy in alone, take a shot, and we've got numbers back supporting that. And to me, I don't know, that makes me it would make me smash a stick or two on the bench too. you get into the zone against Dallas, and you talked about their shot blocking, Gaz. It's just everything's coming from the outside. You're going to get a lot of blocks when you don't let anyone into the house. So, yeah, Colorado has more ozone possession time per game, but they're not generating anything off of it. So it's a combination of factors for those guys. They've had a game now to regroup and hopefully let some of that frustration fade away, because last game you could see it visibly.
You could also see the speed of Drouin. He looked great first game of the playoffs, so that's a little bit of a bright note. And it is clear Devon Taves is good to go, so that's also good. The lone game on the docket in the Lone Star State. We're into Dallas on Hockey Night in Canada next.
This commercial is for shrubs. Those bushes around your house that you probably barely notice. But Proven Winners Color Choice Shrubs can change that. With hydrangeas, roses, and more. All trialed and tested by experts to ensure your success. So you can replace those plain shrubs with new ones that are more reliable and more colorful. Look for Proven Winners Color Choice Shrubs in the white containers at garden centers. Or learn more at ProvenWinnersColorChoice.com.
Ooh, this looks romantic.
Welcome. I'm your host, Chekhov.
Hi.
How was weather getting up here?
Fine, but...
You know, I think we're just going to go up to bed and...
Do you believe in ghosts?
No.
Good. Mother is buried in the yard.
Meanwhile, at Averbo...
When other vacation rentals have no privacy, try one that has no one but you.
We're back. They say to be the champ, you have to beat the champ. Obviously, Dallas got Vegas, last year's winners, and now they're dealing with Colorado. Steve Levy, Ray Ferraro, Emily Kaplan.
Schizmi has allowed two goals or fewer, including allowing just one goal in each of the last two games. And down at the other end, Alexander Georgiev, who was the rock the Avs needed in the first period of Game 4, could have sued for lack of support. That's when Dallas outshot Colorado 16-2, and Georgiev kept them in the game, and only a 1-0 deficit after the first 20 minutes. Referees tonight, Jean Hébert and Garrett Rank, Keel Murchison and Brandon Garlowitz.